Hi friends, good day. In the last class we have seen one problem and how to go for basis of apportionment. In today's class I'll be taking few more problems. So let me begin with this. The partners of Kamal and Vimal decided to convert their existing partnership business into a private limited company called Messrs KV Trading Private Limited with effect from 1st July 2012. The same books of accounts were continued by the company which closed its account for the first term on 31st March 2013. See, whenever you are starting doing the problem, you should be looking at the date. Here, if you look at the date, 1st July 2012. The partners Kamal and Vimal decide to convert their existing partnership business into a private limited company with effect from. That means this is the date on which we assume, if the nothing is mentioned, this is the date of existing partnership business into private limited company. So this is date of This is date of incorporation. The same books of accounts were continued by the company which closed its account for the first term on 31st March 2013. 17 to 31st March is post incorporation. That then we post incorporation period. But now I want pre incorporation. The summarized profit and loss account for the year ended. Year ended means year 1/4/2012 to 31st March 13. Then we got a hint here. What is the hint we got here? Here I am writing. Date of acquisition. Date of incorporation. Date of closing. 31st March. Then you can see this particular period, April, May, June. Three months pre-incorporation. Now from this particular period to this one, it is coming to 9 months. Post incorporation. I think you can see time ratio 3:9 or 1:3. You know that fixed expenses will be apportioned on the basis of time ratio. Then coming back to this, turnover sales ratio, interest on investments, we need to see. Turnover is nothing but sales, interest on investments, cost of goods sold. Turnover minus cost of goods sold will become gross profit, no? Or else you can continue like this by starting splitting turnover in according to their turnover ratio, cost of goods sold also turnover ratio we can do. So advertisement, sales commission, salary, these things generally we have seen that advertisement sales ratio, sales commission sales ratio, salary time ratio, managing director remuneration post, interest on debentures post, rent generally time ratio, bad debts is sales ratio, underwriting commission after formation of company post, audit fees depending upon the information we shall see, loss on sale of investment depending upon the time, depreciation generally time ratio, you know. I think now let us see. The following additional information is provided. That means we are having rough idea But sometimes these items, these ratios may change depending upon the information that is being provided in the problem. Now, let us, if you see this now, the average monthly sales doubled. The average monthly sales doubled. Is this clear? The average monthly sales doubled from 1-7-2002. So now it means from 1-7-2012 the GP ratio was constant. All his investments were sold. I think this is what you need to do. The average monthly sales will be, sales were doubled. GP ratio was constant. There is no change in GP ratio. So I will try to explain this first. Sales ratio, it is there in the solution, but for explanation I am writing it here. So just you should pay attention for listening this, then you can, anyhow the problem has been worked out already. The same problem I am taking out. The average monthly sales doubled from 1-7-2012. It means if you see the beginning, I have told you 1-4-2012, no? So if you assume sales per month, I am assuming as 100. 100 rupees. Okay. Doubled from 1-7-2002 means here, that is sales from 1-4-12 to 30th June 12, then it will be 100 rupees into 3 months, no? 300 rupees. Or you can take X value also. It's your wish. I'm taking as 100 rupees. Then sales from 1-7-12 is double means rupees 200. 100 into 2, no? Double. 200 rupees. Or we can say 2X. I'm taking as a 200 rupees here. Therefore, sales from 1-7-12 to 31st March 13. How many months you will be getting? 9 months, no? So, rupees 200 into 9 months. It is coming to 1800 rupees. Therefore, sales ratio is equal to 300 is to 1800. Or 1:6, like this way. Or 3x is to 18x, is nothing but 1:6 if you assume as 100. I think this is all about your calculation of sales ratio. The first point has been completed. Then we went for time ratio, we went for sales ratio also. Now all investment were sold on 31st May 2012. That is, this is sales made before incorporation. Sales made before incorporation. Therefore, I think interest on investment is pre-incorporation, no? Now, turnover which ratio? Sales ratio. Cost of goods sold. If you don't split it, if you don't want to go for gross profit, we can same thing, we can continue having pre-incorporation column, post-incorporation column. Or if you want to find out gross profit, 240 minus 102, then you get gross profit. That gross profit you need to split according to sales ratio. Or this can be taken in which ratio? Sales ratio. Clear to all of you? So we got sales ratio here. What is sales ratio? I told you 1:6. Cost of goods sold, sales ratio is nothing but 1:6. This is interest on investment, because you have sold investment. So whatever interest on investment which you have received is related to pre-incorporation only, no? Then we also got loss on sale of investment. This is also pre. That reason is it has been sold on 31st May 2012. Okay, clear to all of you? Then next, third point. Average monthly salary doubled from 110 2012. Average monthly salary doubled from 110 2012. So I think this is important point. So third point, this is about second point I've explained. This is time ratio. This is time ratio. Time ratio. This is second point is sales ratio. Now third, investment, I have already explained you. This point I have already explained you. Investment I have already explained you. Now which is important? Salary. The third point here I am doing. Apportionment of salary. Apportionment salary. So you know, salary, monthly salary doubled from 110, that means up to 30th September salary is same. No, so what I am doing, let the salary per month from 1st April is equal to X. Now salary increase, hike in salary, salary per month one ten twelve two, 31st March 13 is 2 times he has said. Double means 2x. So we can say pre incorporation x into 3x, 2x into 9, 18x. No. One minute. This is not 3 months. I have to do it separately. One. Now you can see pre-incorporation 1/4 12 to 30th June. No? 3 months, x into 3, 3x. Now post incorporation we are having old salary plus new salary. Old is 1/7 12 to 30th September 12. This is old salary. What is old salary? X. X into how many months? July, August, September. 3x. Then, this is post-incorporation old salary. post incorporation new salary, there is a hike in the salary from 110, no? 110-12 to 31st March 13. 6 months, no? X into 2X. Because salary has increased, no? Doubled. X into 2X. How many months? 6 months. It is coming to how much? 12x. So if you add 3x plus 12x, 15x is the salary for post incorporation. Simple logic, my dear friends. Pre incorporation is 1/4/12 to 30th June, no? So the old salary was paid up to 30th September. So 30th June is coming under 30th September 2012, no? Therefore, x into 3 is equal to 3x. Post incorporation old salary is being continued even after incorporation up to 30th September 2012. That is 1/7/2012 to 30th September 2012. For how many months we are having? 3 months. So x into 3 is equal to 3x. Plus there is a new salary with effect from 1st October 2012 to 31st March 3. What is new salary we are assuming? Double, no? 2x. 2 times of the first 6 months salary. So 2x into 6 months, it is coming to 12x. So I think we can say now apportionment of salaries on the basis of 3x is to 15x or 3 is to 15 or 1 is to 3. 1 is to 5, sorry. 3 ones are 3 fives are. 1 is to 5. This is which ratio, my dear friend? Apportionment of salary. So here we got salary. We have done working notes, no? It is coming to, what is the ratio? 1 is to 5. It is time, it is not time ratio. It is as per information that is given. It is apportionment time ratio, but not the time ratio on the basis of pre and post incorporation. Managing director remuneration is post. Interest on debentures, I told you, post. Rent we should see. So salary we are having working notes. Salary we are having working notes. Then next. The company occupied additional space from 1/7/2012 for which rent of 20,000 per month was incurred. Is saying that the company occupied additional space from 1/7/2012 for which rent of 20,000 per month was incurred. So additional space from the date of incorporation. This is important point. Working notes number 4. Apportionment of rent. Actually, what happened here? Apportionment of rent means you can see rent is been given. Rent has been given how much? 5.50, no? So this is total rent. This total rent you should understand. Given included additional rent also. So additional rent. Total rent, whenever he is giving total rent, it is including additional rent. What is total rent actually? 5.5 lakhs. Less, I am taking out additional rent from 1/7/12 to 31st March 13. What is additional rent? He said 20,000 per month. So here you can see 1/7 means 9 months, no? 9 months into 20,000, 1,80,000. We are writing in lakhs, no, I am writing 1.8. 1.8 means 1,80,000. If you deduct it, you will be getting 3,70,000. This is rent for, tell me, old premises. Now, you should understand, this rent for old premises is, this is per annum. Per annum means here, I think you will be having confusion. 12 months. So, this 12 months rent we shall apportion on the basis of time ratio. What is time ratio? We have already calculated 1:3. And this, then this will be taken to where? Post incorporation rent. So, that is what we should do. Now, old rent pre post. What is time ratio? We have already calculated in the beginning. 1:3. Take the calculator. 3.70 by 4. 0.925. 0.925, and if you deduct that from, you will be getting 2.775. So, old rent apportion on time basis. New rent exclusively related to post, no? Additional rent. Additional rent means from where, when they have taken additional rent? Additional rent from the date of incorporation, because when company has been, the firm has been converted into company, what happens? Obviously, you need to, what is that you can say, you need additional space for carrying out your business activities, no? This will go to post incorporation, 1.80, then 0.925 you will be getting, pre, 2.775 plus 1.80. 4.575 is post incorporation. That's it. I think this you can easily do it, my dear friend. Not a difficult one. See, I've been saying in every batch, they are very happy to do this chapter. Then next, this also has been completed. Now, bad debts. Bad debts. Bad debts recovered amounting 50,000. For sale made in 2010 has been deducted from bad debts mentioned above. See, bad debts recovered 50,000. This bad debts related to which year? 2010. Recovered has been adjusted from bad debts. A simple logic. I think I need not tell you about, you know the entry for that. Entry for bad debts recovered. Tell me entry for bad debts recovered. Cash to bad debts recovered, no? This is correct entry. Wrong entry has written cash to bad debts. Come on, rectification. I think bad debts is to be closed, no? So, bad debts is to be debited. And which account is to be created? Bad debts recovered is to be created. So, bad debts debited means, since they have already adjusted, here bad debts is to be added. 1 plus 0.5. That is 50,000 is to be added. Why? Because actually bad debts 1.5. Bad debts record has been adjusted from bad debts. Sir, what happens? You will be getting the answer, but that is not correct accounting entry, no? And then that bad debts recovered will be added to income. and this is related to three, because this bad debts recovery is after formation of a company or before formation of company. Bad debts pertaining to before formation of company, so pre. Therefore bad debts. Now bad debts recovery is pre incorporation, but when it comes to bad debts, it is adjusted, but total bad debts is 1.5. this 1.5 is to be apportioned on which ratio? Bad debts turnover ratio. That is turnover ratio we have calculated already, 1:6. Then underwriting commission, post audit fees, I think they have given something. Audit fees pertain to company. Are you following? See, bad debts record has been adjusted from bad debts, my dear friends. You have added back. Total bad debts is 1.5. That 1.5 lakhs is to be apportioned on time basis, no? That means this 1,50,000 is bad debts for the current year. But by mistakenly, bad debts recovery of earlier has been adjusted from bad debts. Because of that, bad debts has come down to 1 lakh. But again, what is actual bad debts? 1,50,000. That 1,50,000 will be split according to time ratio. But what about bad debts recovered? That they are, now you need to record. That bad debts recovered is relating to company, not company. It is related to partnership firm. That is prior incorporation. That to 2010 bad debts were recovered. So it is to be taken as pre-incorporation. That was not adjusted there. That is why we have taken. So audit fees pertains to company. You know that. Audit fees pertain to company means it's post-incorporation only. Depreciation time 1:3. Okay, these all things is there in the solution. To have a clarity, just I've explained, my dear friend. No need to copy down. Just for explanation purpose, I've written this. I hope you can do the problem without any difficulties straight away. Can come back to solution. You can write heading like KV Trading Limited. Statement showing calculation of profit/loss for pre and post incorporation periods. Ratio, total, pre incorporation, post. Sales. See, without gross profit, they converted right from sales also. In this way also you can do. Or what is that you can do? Sales minus cost of goods sold. Gross profit you can split, but the concept will be same. See, what you can do, the sales, from the sales, if you deduct cost of goods sold, then you will be getting gross profit. And that gross profit will be apportioned sales ratio, interest on investment, pre, bad debts record pre. That same thing continue. Advertisement and everything will be deducted. But what we are doing, I think he is cleverly using the, smartly using the problem which is given. Without going for gross profit directly, he is using the same data to make the things simple. So 1:6 ratio, I have explained you. Total pre-incorporation, post-incorporation. Interest on investments, I have told you already, pre, because investments were sold before company formation, no? It is pre. Bad debts recovered pre. Here I have written bad debts recovered pre. Okay. So bad debts recovered pre. So in simple words, you are getting total revenue pre and post. So from this he is deducting. He has given 1 - 2. He has taken this as a 1. Total revenue. 2 is total expenses. 1 - 2 is nothing but net profit. Like that he has given. Cost of goods sold. 1:6. I told you. Advertisement, I have told you. Sales commission. Salary, we have done the notes. MD remuneration, post. This is interest on debenture. This is rent. This is bad debts. Underwriting commission. This is just a typing problem. This is depreciation. I hope you will understand this. This is interest on debenture. This is rent. Bad debts. All those things we have done, the working notes. interest on debentures, I have told you already. Post rent, we have done interest on debentures. I have already told you. Post interest on debentures, working notes 4. Bad debts, I have told you already. Sales ratio, underwriting commission, post audit fees, post as per instruction. Company audit said loss on sale of investment before company formation has been sold. Depreciation, which ratio? Time ratio. So 1 minus 2 net profit. So, and this net profit, you know, actually how to write? You written net profit, but I think one point is missing here. Pre-incorporation profit transferred to capital reserve. This is clear. Pre-incorporation profit means, what is pre-incorporation profit? 18.79 is transferred to capital reserve. That is missing actually, that you should add. Then the sales ratio, how to calculate, is been given here. We have already done that. Time ratio, I have told you already. Salary apportionment, I have told you. Apportionment of rent, I have told you already. Okay, my dear friends. I think you got the clarity on this. So shall I take you to the next problem? This is different problem. This is important model. Third one. Sale Limited was incorporated on 1st August 2011 to take over the business of a partnership from, with effect from 1st April 2011, the following is the extract of P&L account for the year ended 31st March 2012. I think this is simple. Incorporation date has been given already. I think 1412. July 2011 is pre simple. So we got pre and post incorporation. Come on, tell me, what is time ratio? 1st April to 31st July. April, May, June, July. How many months? 4 months. And next is 8. 4 is to 8. Or we can say 4 ones are 4 twos are. 1 is to 2 is which ratio? Time ratio. Okay. So they have already given gross profit. So we need gross profit ratio. Salaries time. Rent and taxes time. Commission on sales. Depreciation time. Interest on debentures. Post, director fees, post, advertisement, post. Is this clear? Sale Limited initiated an advertising campaign which resulted increase in monthly average sales by 25% post incorporation. Sale Limited initiated an advertising campaign which result increase in monthly average sales by 25% post incorporation. This is interesting point. Sales ratio, sales is increased after incorporation by 25%. So it is unlike previous problem. It is unique problem. And then he is saying, the gross profit ratio post incorporation also increased to 30% from 25%. So we are having GP ratio separately. So for the first time, we are having GP ratio in the problem, and it's also sales ratio. You are required to apportion the profit for the year between pre and post, and also explain how pre-incorporation profit is treated in the accounts. I think it is very clear. With this, I can explain working notes. So what he has done here, let the monthly sales for first 4 months, that is from 1st April 2011 to 31st July. I've already given time ratio also has been given here. 1st April is 4 months and then 8 months I have told you. So 4 months salary sales, first 4 months he has assumed as X. R I am writing 100. The other option also I am writing. So 400, it will become 400, no, 4 into 100, 400. Monthly sales for next 8 months increased by how much? 25%. So that means monthly sale is how much? 100 rupees, no, per month actually. Per month is 100. 100 plus 25% of 100, or X plus 25% of X. Simple words. Monthly sales for next 8 months has increased by 25%. If sale is 100, it has increased by 25%. It is nothing but 100 plus 125% means 125 rupees is the sales per month after incorporation. So how many months we are having? 8 months, no? So we can also write like this, 125 into 8 months is equal to 1000 rupees. That's it. So sales for next 6 months. March 1st to 31st. 125 into 8. 1.8 months, sorry. Then sales for next 6 months are 8 months. This is something given wrong here. 8 months. It has to be sales for is not 6 months. Because after incorporation sales has increased to 1000. Therefore, total sales is equal to 400 is to 1000. If for explanation I am taking 100, or you can, if you can understand, you take only X value. 400 is to 1000. So come on, tell me. 4 is to 10. Or 2 is to 5. This is which ratio? Sales ratio. This is peculiar. That means GP ratio, the sales ratio has increased by 25% after incorporation. That is, before incorporation, if it is 100, 25% increase means 100 plus 25%. It is 100 plus 25% of 100. 125 per month. 125 into 8 months is coming to 1000. Pre-incorporation sales is 400. Post-incorporation 1000. It is coming to 4 is to 10 or 2 is to 5. Just this is to understand, I have written here. This is correct only. Typing mistake there. Okay, my dear friends. Then gross profit ratio. Gross profit ratio pre-incorporation 25% on sales. Achha, one more thing here. Total sales he has taken. Why total sales he has taken? Total sales for the entire year. That is 400 plus 1000, no? Is nothing but 1400. This is also why this has been given like this. Because GP ratio we need to calculate. So GP ratio is 25% of sales up to 31st July. So 25% of 4x is equal to 1x. 25% of 400 is equal to 100. See, 400 rupees is sales, 100 rupees is gross profit. Then gross profit for next 8 months has increased to 30%. So 30% of 1000 is 300, or 30% of 10x 3x. Therefore, GP ratio is how much? 1 is to 3. time ratio has already been given. Now we can see the solution. Gross profit, since GP ratio has been given, we are going for apportionment on the basis of GP ratio. GP. Salary is time. We already calculated time. What is the time ratio, my dear friends? We have done 1:2. Rent and rates, 1:2. Sales commission, we have done that. Working notes, 2:5. Depreciation time, interest on debentures post, director fees post, advertisement, because you can see why post has been taken advertisement. Initiated advertisement campaign, which resulted increase in monthly post incorporation. That means this advertisement expenses has been taken as post. The reason is that generally advertisement is based on sales ratio. No, why it has been taken as a post? Because they have initiated the advertisement campaign after incorporation. That is why it has been taken as a post. Then net profit is this much. Pre-incorporation, post. Actually, the question, they haven't answered this. What was the question actually? How pre-incorporation profit is treated in the accounts? I think that is missing. That is missing. That you should write. Pre-incorporation profit is will be credited. Pre-incorporation profit will be created to capital reserve because of its capital nature. That's it. Okay, that statement you can write. So, let me take out one more problem. Yeah, I've got two problems here. So, let me begin with a small problem. First, Rama Udyog Limited was incorporated on 1st August 2011. It had acquired a running business of Rama & Co. with effect from 1st April 2011. I think by this time you are good in knowing that what is time ratio. Incorporated 1st August with effect from 1st April. 1st April to 31st July. April, May, June, July, 4 months. During the year 2011-12 means they are closing books on 31st March 2012. So August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March. How many months you are getting there? 10 months, no? Huh? August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March. How many months? 8 months. 8 months is post-incorporation. Pre-incorporation 4 months. Time ratio 4:8 or 1:2. During the year, total sales were 36 lakhs. The sales per month in the first half year were half of what they were in the last half year. The sales per month in the first half of year were half of what they were in the later half year. Simple words, if sales for first half year means 6 months, is say 100 rupees. Sales for next remaining 6 months is 200. Simple words, current year sales has been doubled. That has been given a different way. The sales per month in the first half year were half of what they were in the later half year means. So the next, or you can do like this. Next 6 months is 100, this 6 months is 50. Now 50, if you double it, you are getting 100, no? See, instead of saying that, this is something which you say you are giving credit to post incorporation. The sales has increased. Or you can say like this. The sales for post incorporation 2 times of pre incorporation. Sales for post incorporation is 2 times of pre incorporation. That's it. Simple. But what you should do? 4 months is say 100. 4 months is 100 only. Then 2 months after incorporation, total post incorporation 8 months, no? So 2 months again old ratio only. 100 into 2, 200. Then remaining 6 months double. Double means 6 into 200, 1200. 1200 plus 2, 400. 1400. 1400 plus 400. 400 is to 1400 that you will be getting it. Are you following? I think that you should work out. That way you should work out the problem. So I think you got the clarity of this. I am giving 1 minute time. You calculate for yourself. Sales ratio clear to you? Time ratio is clear. Pre-incorporation. One is to 10 time ratio, then sales ratio. Sales ratio. Let us assume sales per month for first 6 months. Next 6 months, 2 times. Now, pre-incorporation sales. Hundred into 4, 4. Post incorporation sales. We are having 2 periods, no? Pre incorporation sales is correct. Post incorporation 1811. So what happened? First 6 months is said. First 6 months 100. Out of first 6 months, 4 months has gone. So post incorporation. Into 100, 200. 1, 10, 11, that is next 6 months, it has doubled. That is 6 months into 200. It is coming to 1200. So what is the sales here? 1400. So pre incorporation 400, post incorporation 1400. Therefore, ratio is equal to 200 is to. Let me write 400 is to 1400. Okay. R4 is to 14. 2 is to 7 is the sales ratio. Then up to this is clear. A total sales 336 lakhs has been given. So this 36 lakhs is to be adjusted. How it is to be adjusted? in the ratio of, come on, tell me, in the ratio of 2:7. We don't actually, sales is you needed or gross profit? Gross profit, if we can get gross profit, that can be splitted. Sales is completed. The net profit of the company has been given. I need GP ratio, no? The previous problem, I think we have taken sales. Or else we can, if we can get gross profit, why should I need sales? Gross profit, net profit 2 lakhs. After charging, that means after deducting depreciation, director fees, preliminary expenses, office expenses, selling expenses, interest to vendors. If you add all those things to net profit, you'll be getting gross profit, no? This is net profit after deducting all these items. If you add back all these items to net profit, you'll be getting gross profit. Then we can do the problem. Simple. That is what has been done here. Working notes number 3, gross profit. Net profit plus all expenses is gross profit. And I've already explained the time ratio. If you want, we can see this one also. He has taken X value, I have taken 100, that's it. Time ratio also has been given. Now let us see the problem. The expenses, let us see. Depreciation, which ratio? Time ratio. Director fees, post. Preliminary expenses, post. Office expenses, time. Selling expenses, sales. Interest to vendors up to August 31st, 2011, 5000. This is important. Interest to vendor. See, date of incorporation is 1st August. But the interest was paid up to 31st August. That means, here I am giving small explanation. First April 11 to 31st August 11. For calculate April, May, utter. Okay. April, May, June, July, August. That is for how many months? 5 months. Now, in this case, pre-incorporation, $5,000 is 5 months, no? For 4 months. How much? 4,000. Post-incorporation, $5,000 by 5, how much? 1,000. So I think we got now pre-incorporation interest and post-incorporation interest. Pre-incorporation interest is 4,000. Post-incorporation interest is 1,000. Got it? I think let us see gross profit. We have seen already ratio. Gross profit, we got it now. Gross profit, which ratio? Sales ratio. This is time. Director fees, post, preliminary post, office expenses, time, selling expenses, sales, interest on actual, 4,000 pre, post 1,000. Then net profit. Here, like this, you should write for previous problem that has missed somewhere. I have written pre-incorporation profit is transferred to capital reserve account. Post-incorporation profit is as always created to profit and loss account. No? Okay, is this clear? So, I think these are the items after deducting from gross profit. This is less after deducting all these expenses. This is pre-incorporation profit. This is post-incorporation. Both will go to reserves and surplus. This will go to reserves and surplus in company accounts as P&L account credit balance. This will appear as capital reserve in reserves and surplus. Both will appear in reserves and surplus. But the question is that pre-incorporation is transferred to capital reserve. Post-incorporation will appear as same P&L account credit balance only. Okay. Now let us see the second problem. The promoters of Glorious Limited took over on behalf of the company a running business with effect from 1st April 2011. The promoters of Glorious Limited took over on behalf of the company a running business with effect from 1st April 2011. The company got incorporated on 1st August 2011. So 1st April incorporation, 1st August. So April, May, June, July, 4 months. 31st March, same ratio previous problem. And the total sales for the whole year total 1600 lakhs, out of which sales till 31st July were 400 lakhs is. So 31st July, that means 1600 lakhs is total sales. Out of 1600 lakhs total sales, four hundred lakhs is for up to 31st July 2011. It is very simple. So pre-incorporation sales is 400, post-incorporation sales is 1200. Exactly splitting point he has given. See, the splitting point is 31st July is the 31st July is the last day of running business other than company. So up to that 400 lakhs, out of 1600, if you take out 400, you'll be getting 1200. Gross profit ratio also given. Okay, we'll see what is significance. Time ratio also has been given. This is a simple problem, you can do it. Come on, I am going to ask you, you should tell me. In GP ratios, which was given, sales was given, that I'll come back to that. Salaries, tell me which ratio. Time, rent, time, travelers commission is sales. Why sales? Because on business tour they'll be going, travelers commission, sales related, discount allowed sales. Okay, bad debt sales, director fees post, tax audit fees, we have discussed already, sales, depreciation on tangible assets, time, debenture interest, debenture means after incorporation of company only, so post incorporation, okay, is this clear? So we need gross profit. That gross profit, since GP ratio was given 25% to 1600, we can get gross profit. Simple words. Cancel solution, gross profit 25% of 1600. And that sales splitting has been given for us to find out sales ratio. Whatever I have explained, the same thing. You can see. Okay, net profit, this will be transferred to where? Capital reserve, that you should mention in all the problems. Pre-incorporation profit is transferred to pre-incorporation profit is transferred to capital reserve. Okay, clear to all of you? I think this is all today's class. I think this is the last problem. With this, I'm concluding the day. Concluding today's class. I think this is simple chapter, no? You all agree with me. It's only that you need to practice a lot. These all are there in the study material. I told you to, you can download from your system or a mobile phone. These things I am explaining. My own main focus is I am emphasizing on explanation, because generally what we do, I used to work out the problems from study material. Then these problems second time I used to take up. Now almost the values have changed, but models are same. But we are having one or two advanced models in this advanced problems, in the sense like with some adjustments. Generally examination, you also seen CA Foundation, generally paper setter will be looking at your study material first. Very rarest rare cases he may be going out of the study material, but the basic concept is same. So what I am trying, every chapter my intention is to see that we are covering the problems from study material. Generally I do before examination. So I think same thing I'm taking now, because of present circumstances. I think this is what, if I feel that I need to work out, like I have done in company final accounts, I have worked out. Otherwise I think the problem that has been worked out appears to be neat on the screen. Only you need explanation. That is why I am having gaps in between to explain that. I hope you all have been following this, right? So even the redemption of preference shares chapter or bonus shares, these topics also with the entries part where I need to explain, that I am giving. Otherwise, but anyhow, having said, better copy down. You have to practice either copying down or without looking at the screen and working out on your own in cross checking, but you should practice. And I think I know the most of you have done that in CA Foundation. Definitely you know the result of it. Like practicing is very, very important. Then once practice complete, just fine tuning, you can have a look at it. Okay, and hope you have not forgotten the previous, you have not forgotten the previous chapters. What are the previous chapter? Insurance claims, hire purchase, single entry. Clear? I think those topics you might have gone through it. So practice, keep on practicing. Single entry is very important chapter. Don't neglect that. Insurance claims is also equally important. Hire purchase, these three chapters, you have to be good in it. Okay. So we'll meet in the next class. Till then, goodbye. Thank you. God bless you all.